now. Okay, this message is for Brian Willis and Bruce Willis, for all of you. Brian, you had a conversation with Gabriel today. You added him as a friend after finding his post at the Knights of Malta. You sent him the link to the Rael, Lord Rael site. And the conversation that you had with Gabriel was interesting. I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt, Brian, because you're in a very grave, and I mean that literally, situation right now. It would seem at the moment that you have rejected the news that the Christ has returned because you had a visitation 8 years ago with your Jesus. Well, I'm going to tell you a few things, Brian, and give you another chance. First of all, the Christ is rejected. That's what he prophesied as Jesus, that he would have to suffer many things of this evil generation before the revealing of the Son of Man. Now, he is back this time, not as the young dude, not the 33-year-old that went to the cross. The 33-year-old that went to the cross, the heavenly presence is the archangel Michael. He is the one that appears to those in dreams or visions, confront up around the globe, give people a message. You said to Gabriel, well, why weren't you told 8 years ago that the Christ is on the earth? Because it is a game. I'm going to liken it to a game. You see, the angels are under strict instructions. Not only are they not able to help the Christ in his flesh body, that's all part of the instructions, they are not able to give themselves away should they have an earthly encounter with us or appear in a vision or a dream. They are not allowed to give the game away. So you had your visitation, you thought it was the Christ. Well, Michael is the heavenly presence of Jesus. He didn't tell you that the Christ is on the earth because they are bound. They can't. And it's up to you and your powers of, actually it's humility. I was going to say discernment, but discernment. True discernment causes all of us to be really humble. You said that God can do anything. He can. You want him to front up to you again and give you a message. Well, at this point, he's about ready to tell you to take a hike out of here. First of all, your riches offend him. All of your friends, your rich friends, offend him. And there's a little scripture that still holds. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God, which comes upon the earth, because the King of Kings is in residence upon the earth. You see, the earth is his temple. Until this time, when souls were released from their bodies at death, they went into a period of no time, rested for a while to be sent back. All souls reincarnate, Brian. You may not believe that because it's not part of Orthodox Christian teaching. It has been removed. And since Jesus was and is an Essene, it was very much part of the teaching that he gave, for example, Nicodemus, the night he came to him. What you would have been reading if you are remaining within the framework of a Bible, you have got the short version of the very lengthy conversation that actually went down The night that Nicodemus went to Jesus and asked him, what does it mean to be born again? And Jesus told him very plainly, to be born again means that you must be born again of the spirit or the soul and of the flesh, the water and the flesh, meaning to reincarnate into another body of flesh. And he likened it to the sun rising and setting, rising in the east, setting in the west, going down, to rest for a little until it rises again, until the end of the age, which is now. It's the end of the age or the end of times, because all souls have been given up to seven times to reincarnate upon the earth, live their lives, and get it right. What does it mean to get it right? Reach the righteousness and maturity and the recognition of the truth of who the Christ is. In his second incarnation, as he has had to come into hell once again to set the captives free, what was accomplished at the cross was accomplished in the spiritual realm. The earth moves at 69,000 kilometers per hour. Our solar system moves northward. When he told his disciples how to pray, as they asked, it was to keep them occupied, if you like, biding time, knowing that the earth would have to cross physically back to the north side of the equatorial line of the Milky Way galaxy. So in other words, it had to travel a long, long way in the 1910 years until he would be back on the earth again. This is where we started at the cross, and this is where we are when he was reborn back to the earth on the most holy day of January the 11th in 1944. He is the 111. Also, if you read your scriptures closely, you will understand that he said, unless I go, then the Comforter cannot come. Or unless I go, then the Father cannot send the Comforter, or I cannot send the Comforter. You see, the Comforter and the Father are the one and the same. It was never Jesus, the young dude, coming back. And if you have not been expecting him back in his flesh body as an Orthodox Christian, then even there is something wrong with what it is that you have been taught in even your manipulated teachings that you have believed throughout your Orthodox Christian life. Now, the Christ is back in his body of flesh. We all have two angels that look just like us, the younger and the older, just as Michael is the heavenly presence of the young dude known as Jesus. However, Gabriel is the older, is his angel as the old man, the angel of the Lord. Now, the young man that you spoke to, Gabriel, has been under the very close direction. His whole life has been orchestrated very closely by Gabriel. So much so that the synchronicities of his life as a small boy, a young man growing up, the time he spent in Egypt, virtually as a caretaker of the altar to the Lord in the midst of Egypt, from Isaiah 19 and 20, which is the Great Pyramid at Giza, it is the witness for this time now. And it's all about the Christ in his second incarnation. Gabriel gave you the message. Gabriel is the messenger. And he has been trumpeting, if you like, his whole life has been purposed without his understanding, without your understanding, has been purposed for the conversation that you had today with Gabriel and to learn that the Christ is in his body of flesh. Now, Michael didn't tell you 8 years ago because The end game is for you to arrive to the truth on your own. They don't give away information. And I would say to you that if they were going to tell anybody specifically where the Christ is, how to find him, and that he was, that they would have told me in my 9 years of searching for the Christ upon the earth in his body of flesh. However, that is not the rules of engagement. They will give you seed, they will give you food for thought, they will prompt you to open your mind and to, I call it, download information, to open your mind to understand certain things, so that by the time you come across the ultimate truth, which is finding the Christ in his body of flesh upon the earth, this is where the kingdom comes to, the whole point of the Lord's Prayer, then you will have humbled yourself and understood that you don't know everything, and that there has been an almighty prevention. Protocol number 14 from the protocols of the learned elders of Zion, we shall forbid Christ. Why? Because even they knew that he would come again as a man, a body of flesh. And because they are rich and own all of the media, they control every facet of our communication, then they can and have been preventing the news that the Christ is upon the earth from being made public throughout all of the nations. What they didn't plan for was the humility and the pure spirit within Pope Benedict, who, once he retired, had opportunity to communicate with the Christ after one of our faithful disciples, a woman and a German, who herself recognized the Christ years ago, did the research, turned up all of the information that he's been telling the world for a very long time about his lineage as the direct descendant from King David through the righteous Nathan, not through Solomon, who was a black witch that the British royal family take much pride in espousing to be their bloodline. The Christ bloodline is through Nathan, down through William the First, the Lion King of Scotland, who had a son, Henry Golightly, with his second wife, Isabel de Avenel. Henry had a son, Patrick. Patrick was warned to stay away from the throne, hence the name Golightly. It was all part of the divine plan to protect the bloodline. You see, the key of the house of David, Isaiah 22:22, is all about the genetic bloodline, the key of the house of David. And it is the Christ who is the most royal man upon the earth. And he has no time throughout all of his life. He has been abused, rejected, scoffed at, ripped off by wealthy people, which is all very well because he's here for his judgment. You see, the time for forgiveness is past. It's a thing of the past. It is all about the judgment. He has had to witness for himself, be amongst us. You know that song, "What if God were one of us, riding on a bus?" Well, he is. You see, people behave just as they are. Let the evil be evil. Let the righteous remain righteous. The words of the revelation, since we have all been born into the period of time. Since his rebirth, January 11th, 1944, it's the period of time that is called the resurrection. All of us are in the resurrection now. And we've been raised either to life or unto death. Now, the earth is hell. And as I scoured your Facebook page and found out a little about you, you being the founder of the Elite Billionaires VIP Club, I was actually sickened. You see, we've been in hell all of this time. So if anybody is rich or famous, has the wealth that you paint the picture, perhaps you don't. Perhaps you're just painting a picture. But based upon that picture, you are serving the devil. He's in control of hell, and you only make it fabulous wealth, riches, etc., if you're serving the devil. Many give glory to God. That would be all of Christendom. The beast.
Those fingers in my hair that sly come hither still, that strips my conscience bare, it's witchcraft. And I've got no defense for it, the heat is too intense for it.
What you heard, Frank, it's witchcraft. Gabe told you today that the Christians who are praying, believing that they're being influenced by the Holy Spirit and hearing all kinds from their Jesus, it's the Holy Spirit of Baphomet. You see, it's Jesus. He said, nobody has seen nor has anybody heard God. Not Moses. If anybody was talking to Moses, it was Lucifer. It's the same with Christendom today. Nobody is hearing from God, not in their prayer time, not in their quiet times, not as they are reading or scouring the scriptures that are written by dead men for dead men. That's the charge that he had against the priests as Jesus, that they were scouring the scriptures hoping to find life in them, when they were written by dead men for dead men as they rejected the living word of God, who man infested in his flesh body, first time and second time. Besides which, all of the words that have been written and recorded and put together in the Bible are nothing but a trap. It's Freemasonry. And the book within the book is not in the words, but it's in the numbers. That's why he is so intent on measuring his temple, which is the earth. It's converted to a number once you have the measure. And then using the James Strong concordance of King James 1611 Bible only, that number is converted to language to reveal the truth. You see, it is he as the Comforter and the Father who reveals all things to us and abides with us forever on the earth. And when we reach the immortality, we reach immortality when we reach the perfection of our soul, having recognized him who is the face of the Shroud of Turin, which is the blatantly obvious for the pure in heart, like Pope Benedict. A man who had reached the pinnacle as far as the eyes of the world, but he humbled himself when he realized that he was indeed looking at the image recorded within the Shroud of Turin. For this time now, technology. The image on the Shroud of Turin is the image of the soul of Jesus, which is the Father. The old man, not the young dude that went to the cross for the last year. So Brian Willis, I suggest that you continue to watch the videos and ditch your Jesus. You have been led to the truth, and you are given an opportunity to digest it and come to terms with it, and then do something about it. If not, you can rest assured the instruction has already gone out, because all judgment has been given over to Gabriel to remove your soul. That means at the death of your body, your flesh body, your soul will be taken out and destroyed, never to exist again. Immortality is only for those who recognize God and the sacrifice that he has made, not only with his life on the cross, but the 70 years of the suffering, the abuse, the rejection, to reveal all things to a deluded